In this video, we will look at performing 3 and 4-point editing. You're probably used to doing this in your other editing applications, and Autodesk Smoke also provides this functionality. Let's start off with a 3-point edit. Select your source clip in the library, and this will be loaded into the source viewer. Using the navigation controls, you can scrub to the start frame and click the Mark In button or press I to set your endpoint. Scrubbing further down the clip, you can click the Mark Out button or press O to set your out point. In the sequence, first check the patch panel to ensure your tracks are correctly assigned. Now move your positioner to the point where you would like the edit to take place. If you do not place an in or out point, the positioner will be used as the in point. Click the Mark In button or press the I keyboard shortcut to set the in point in the sequence. You can now choose to overwrite or insert the edit into the sequence. You can press the buttons in the interface, or you can use the keyboard shortcuts. You can press F9 to perform an insert edit. Or you can press F10 to perform an overwrite edit. If you just use the positioner or an endpoint in the sequence, this will forward time the edit. But if you only use an outpoint in the sequence, this will backtime your edit. Smoke can also perform a 4-point edit. But both source and sequence must be marked up with the in and out points. In a lot of cases, the duration of the marked up source does not match the duration of the marked up sequence. So in this instance, Smoke will perform a fit to full operation using a time warp effect to fit the source clip to the marked up section of the sequence. To some, time warp is referred to as a speed change. To perform a 4-point edit, ensure your source clip has in and out points. If you wish to create an in and out point based on a selection, press X. Next, ensure your sequence also has a defined in and out point. When you click the overwrite button or press F10, you will see the new segment fitting into the sequence. Notice that a timeline effects was added to the new segment. The timeline effects is indicated by this bar running just under the top of the segment. If you select the segment in the sequence, the effects toolbar will update with the segment settings. If you don't see the effects toolbar, click the effects button to expand it above the sequence. In the effects pipeline, you will see a time warp timeline effects. If you click the button, it will show the speed change that has been applied to the segment to fit it into the sequence. You'll learn more about the effects pipeline in later videos. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.